ओके
विल स्टार्ट लेट देम ज्वाइन इन फ्यू सेकंड्स. ओके सो दिस इज व्हाट वी हैव सीन अबाउट द वेनमस स्नेक बाइट पॉइजनिंग. ओके सो यू हैव टू रिमेम्बर टाइप्स ऑफ स्नेक्स क्लासिफिकेशन व्हाट इज द लेवल ऑफ टॉक्सिसिटी एंड व्हाट काइंड ऑफ टॉक्सिसिटी दे मे लीड टू एंड देन व्हाट कुड बी द पैथोफिजियोलॉजी इन्वॉल्व्ड इन द ऑल डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ स्नेक बाइट पॉइजनिंग and then early sign, later sign and treatment. Okay, so you have to remember all these things. Okay, then we'll see one of the again the small kind of lapland or all those thing, that kind of thing poisoning. Okay, see, you have that envenoming with arthropods bite and stings. Okay, so these arthropods are the most diverse, widespread and numerous of all animal phyla inhabiting the planet. Okay, and not surprisingly their contact with human is a common occurrence. Okay, so this is one of the again small kind of animal which can be having the again poisoning. Okay, because might be due to this you have seen the various kind of arthropods. Okay, so depending upon the their fangs or stings. Okay, so this is what will happen. Okay, and they are the like generally there is a more contact with the humans. Okay, so these are the some of the types. Okay, of the arthropods which are classified or grouped based on the similarity of organism and clinical finding. Okay, so based upon their similarity of their structure, okay, or their clinical finding, we have classified as hymenoptera, which are nothing but bees, wasps, horns, yellow jackets, and ants. Okay, the second thing you have arachnids. Okay, so spider, ticks, and scorpions are the part of the arachnids. Okay, then you have centipede, paris, millipedes, and caterpillar, and scabies, fleas, and lice. Okay, so generally you have come across with, I hope that first of all, bees, ants, spiders, scorpion, okay, caterpillar, lice. Okay, so I hope that you have seen all these kind of arthropods. Okay, so you know what is like, if you see the lice, okay, like is a very few, like you, if I say in a high in size, it could be a like very like micro centimeter or nano centimeter. Okay, this small. Okay, but what will happen, like most of you know that if you have lices in your head, hair, okay, so what you'll see, you have that itching kind of problem and all those things, and you, no one will like this kind of lices in your hair. Okay, so this is what will happen. So once what will happen, if lice is there, they will again multiply into your head, hair only, and they are the, like spreading to one to the another, all those things. Okay, so this is what, based upon that similarity. Okay, so we will see one by one. Okay, so what is their epidemiology? Okay, see, epidemiology, you aware about this term? Okay, so there is a two difference. One is the epidemiology and one is prevalence rate. Okay, so I want you, any one of you or any like who can answer, what is the difference between epidemiology and prevalence rate? Guys, what is the difference between epidemiology and prevalence rate?
Sir, epidemiology is the branch of science which deals with the incidence.
Sorry?
Distribution. Epidemiology is a branch of medicine.
No.
It deals with the incidence.
No. Incidence. Okay, correct. That is correct. And what is prevalence rate? Yeah, please tell. What is the prevalence rate? Anyone, it's not like that. At least you speak out whatever you have. See, earlier, I don't know the who told the answer about epidemiology. So it's okay. At least you try now. Tell guys, what is prevalence rate? See, okay, I think no one is ready to answer. This is what like prevalence epidemiology, like how many, like if I'll give you the example, okay. See, epidemiology, you can say like in a surrounding area, okay, suppose any area you take, okay, in that particular area, if you have 10,000 people, okay, and they are suffering from this kind of any kind of disease or disorder, okay, so you will mention that epidemiology of diabetes is more found out in the India, okay. See, we take excuse me. So we'll take the example of this diabetes. See, you have read about this diabetes epidemiology. So in many of books or many of articles, it has been mentioned that in future by 2025 or 2030, India will consider as a diabetes capital of in the world. Okay. So this is what they have there thing. Okay. And when we come to the prevalence rate, okay. So prevalence rate, we can consider as a like newly diagnosed or newly identifying the disease in a particular specific group of people. Okay. See, if I say 10,000 people are suffering in the particular area from that. Okay. So now you have to segregate. Okay. See, you have to segregate between in what age group. Okay. What's kind of gender, okay, and what kind of people they have any other comorbidities, okay, along with the diabetes and all those things. So you need to identify all those things. So this is what called prevalence rate. So we'll say now, okay, we have 10% prevalence rate in that particular area, okay. So 10% means if you have 1,000 people, okay, so 10% are suffering from diabetes. So means out of 1,100 people are suffering. So therefore you are mentioning the 10%. Okay. So this is what you call the prevalence rate. And then from 10%, if you again want to separate like difference between the male and female. Okay. So you can say like 4% female and 6% male. Okay. So this is one of the again prevalence rate. Okay. And again, you want to differentiate between 6%, how many people above 40 or above 50, or how many people are below 50, and how many people are having type 1 and type 2 diabetes mellitus. So this is how you can make a difference or between the different kind of age group and all those things. So this is how you can identify the prevalence rate. Okay. So here we have seen, we'll see the epidemiology. Okay, so arthropod venoms are complex mixture of enzymes. So as we have seen in the this one, see snake bite, there is a protein mixture. Okay, that is a complex mixture of protein. So here arthropod venoms are complex mixture of enzymes, protein and histamine, and it may also involve the other bioamines which can either damage tissue directly or elicit an allergic response. Obviously, see, when there is a, some of the bioamines and histamines are there, so there will be chance, okay? So there will be chance that any person can be allergic to that particular arthropod bites, okay? See, many of time if you see, if any ant will bite, you will have some kind of will response or redness on your skin, okay? So this is what a particular person is allergic to the ant bite. And sometime what will happen, a small bite of any kind of arthropod may lead to the may lead to the allergic to the full body. Okay, you will find a small blister to the whole body. Okay, so this is what it may lead to the. Okay, so the venom of each family could be a unique. Okay, so we have seen three category. One, we have seen Haemoptera. Okay, then we have seen that caterpillar and all those things. Okay, so each family arthropods having the different type of venom. You cannot generalize, or you cannot make claim that all things will be a similar. Okay, so there will be a local tissue reaction from dermal exposure to the arthropod antigen, result in the common pruritic urticarial and papular lesions seen after envenomation. Okay, so this common thing you can see. So this all, like pruritic, urticarial and papular lesion, see, all this thing will be relatable to the allergy. Okay, so this can be appear because what will happen, arthropod antigen can lead to this, all this condition. Okay, sometime what will happen, there could be a chance of life threatening complication of arthropod exposure will be there, because it may lead to the anaphylaxis, either to the venom itself or to the anti-venom administered. Okay, so why there will be anaphylaxis, because we have seen above only. So sometime what will happen, many of people will have small allergy or very like for a few hours allergy, and if you take any anti-allergic tablet you can avoid. But what will happen if any person is allergic to the venom itself, and sometime the anti-venom which are administering, it may be again the having the allergy to the particular patient. Okay, so it may lead to the anaphylaxis, and you know there will be a, if anaphylaxis is there, so it may also lead to the shock like condition. Okay, you might study about that anaphylactic shock. Okay, so this is what will happen. Okay, then there will be a treatment of anaphylaxis merits become a crucial. Okay, so this is what make the condition worsen when any person who could be allergic to that venom again and allergic to the anti venom which is going to be administer. Okay, so that time your treatment strategy will be for the anaphylaxis, to overcome from this anaphylaxis. And this is very critical situation. It is not like easy thing that you can cure that patient from the anaphylaxis. It may a time taken process. Okay, so here I'll stop you here. If you and one more thing, I have only received 10 or 11 student assignment. Why not others are submitting? CR, Siddharth and Vini.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, why your class people have not submitted the assignment? Only I list out, Siddharth, that only 11 people sent me the assignment yet. I think everyone got the slides, right? All six chapter, whatever we have covered.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Then please, guys, if you have not done, please send it today evening. No issue. Okay. And the new guy who joined, right? I think Siddharth. So you please share the details or slides to him. If he had any doubt, you can ask him to ask me any question or any doubt. If you have any time, he can ask. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay, dear. Chalo. Thank you. Take care. Bye.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.